I'm gonna get a lot of he's evil, he's the Antichrist, he's the Marilyn Manson of rap. I'm ready for it.
Meet Eddie, 23 years old. Fed up with life and the way things are going, he decides to rob a liquor store.
It's like a song about like a devil on one shoulder and an angel on one shoulder, and I'm trying to like bring him to the dark side again, you know what I mean? And like persuade somebody to do bad, you know? I guess that is me.
Now before you walk in the door of this liquor store and try to get money out the drawer, you better think of the consequence.
Who are you?
I'm your mother conscience.
That's nonsense. Go in, gap for the money and run to one of your aunt's cribs and borrow a damn dress to one of a blonde wig.
My thing is, until you've lived my life, don't judge me. Don't judge anything I say. And everything that I say is not to be taken so literally.
So you rap about raping and killing women, but you really don't do that, do you, Eminem?
Yes.
You do rape and kill women?
Yes.
Are you amazed at the firestorm that has begun, and are you afraid it could be a career destroyer?
I'm not worried about it, because anybody with half a brain is going to be able to tell when I'm joking and when I'm serious.
Now listen to me, while you're kissing her cheek and smearing her lipstick. Now all you gotta do is nibble on this little chicken's earlobe.
Yo, this girl's only 15 years old. How could you take advantage of her? She's passed out.
It's easy, just cut these lights out, that's how.
They could not be more despicable. They could not be more hateful in their attitudes toward women in particular. There are many groups that Eminem is quite despicable toward, but he is a violent misogynist.
Like, when people call me a misogynist, I'm like, I can see where they're coming from in a way, but a lot of it is jokes, because I say a lot of outlandish stuff towards men in the same token, and I don't discriminate nobody.
Does any of the material on this record disturb you at all? I mean, if you were a woman, would you feel differently, do you think?
No, you're talking to a guy that created NWA, you know what I'm saying? So I'm the wrong person to ask that question.
Yeah.
Nothing disturbs me.
All right, calm down, relax, start breathing.
Start breathing, man, you just caught your wife cheating. While you at work, she's with some dude trying to get off. Forget getting divorced.
What if there's a good explanation for this?
Why? She tripped, fell, landed on his...
It's like acting. I mean, it's like a little movie. How does that get recorded? Does he write that stuff out?
Well, let's just say there's a lot of drugs involved.
Yeah, no.
Yo, everybody in this club likes your trucks up. And if you fucked up, say, I'm fucked up.
Drop out of school and do drugs.
Me personally, I don't see what the big deal is. If I want to get some weed, I'm going to get some weed.
True.
You know what I'm saying? If I want to get drugs, I'm going to get drugs, whether they're legal or whether they're not.
Yeah.
We should have a job.
Oh. Don't try that at home.
Are you getting tired of defending yourself? Because I feel bad. Like, every time they're always saying, the lyrics.
You feel
but
like
all I can
saying,
say is,
yo, shut up.
If you don't like the album, don't get it.
I've said that before.
Susan, stop crying. I don't hate you. The world's not against you. I'm sorry your father raped you. So what, you had your little coochie in your dad's mouth? That ain't no reason to start wigging and spaz out.
It, lyrics are very provocative. Let's not ignore that. And that's going to bother people. You know, it bothered my parents. It bothered my parents' parents.
Part of the evolution and part of the importance of hip-hop is that it's talking about things that are out there, pleasant or unpleasant, real or fantasy, in a way that, you know, pop music isn't focusing on.
I'm so sick of the motherfucking Backstreet Boys, motherfucking NSYNC, fucking Men Stink.
I mean, when you hear Eminem, a lot of times people bring up color, but his lyrics are so hot.
Come on, lady. Come on, spit something. Spit something.
Spit something.
Off the
but
top.
I ain't read nothing. Right off the top. I never softly drop rhymes like these. Cause none of y'all MCs can see me. Even if I duck down like Proof did, I leave you toothless and knock you while the guy was ruthless. Any MC who try to step to this, my neck just twists and spin like the Exorcist. And I ain't even high yet, so just imagine what I can do when I get a little Henny in me and start rapping.
And he kind of exemplifies what hip-hop is. It's a struggle. It's a kind of anger. It's a kind of point of view. It's a kind of happiness. It's kind of fun. So he kind of embodies that.
And the winner is Best Hip-Hop, Eminem. And the winner is Eminem, My Name Is.
Give it up for Mr. Slim Shady himself, Eminem.
Uh-oh. Was this supposed to happen?
Now, do I worry about going too far? No.